Want to learn Turkish anywhere, anytime? Get the Innovative Language 101 app for free.
Hi everyone, it's Celine, and welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. Yay! Today we're gonna speak Turkish together. Okay, let's start. I'm really excited about the topic, so let's go and see. Fruits! Yay, finally about fruits. I'm so happy. Fruits. I really like fruits. Meyveler in Turkish. If you want to say fruit, then it's meyve. Meyve is fruit. Meyveler, plural form, is fruits. Yeah, simple, right? Meyve. Ananas. Pineapple. I think I really like ananas. And did you know, like, if you eat ananas, then it helps you lose weight. Yeah, I checked a lot. I searched a lot about it. It doesn't grow in Turkey. Yeah, like not everyone is eating, or it's not so popular in Turkey, maybe. Ananas kilo vermene yardımcı olur, which means pineapple helps you lose weight. It's important, right? Kavun, melon. I think it's my, sorry, but least favorite fruit. I don't know why. I'm sorry, kavun. I really don't like you. So my example is, of course, kavunu sevmiyorum. I don't like melon. Sevmiyorum means I don't like, I don't love. So I don't like melon. Kavunu sevmiyorum. I said it so dramatically, maybe. Kavunu sevmiyorum. No, like maybe it sounds better like that. Kavunu sevmiyorum. Elma. Apple. Oh, it's cute, right? It's, I don't know why did I say cute to a fruit. I think apple is cute. In old times in Turkey, maybe in Turkish villages, if you have someone you love but you're just too shy to show your love, and in old times in Turkey it was kind of not so okay to show your love, so the girl was giving an apple to a guy. It means I love you. So if the girl just gives the apple to the guy understands, oh, maybe this girl has feelings for me, maybe like that. Her gün elma yemek sağlığınız için çok iyidir. It means like eating apple every day is good for your health. Çilek, strawberry. Oh, that's my favorite. I really like strawberry. Even when I speak about strawberry, I'm so happy. Çilek is awesome. Even like the sound is nice, right? Çilek. It's like something even cuter than apple. Çilek. Strawberry. So that is why my example is, of course. Her gün çilek yiyebilirim. I can eat strawberries every day, which is true. Her gün means every day, as I said before. Her gün çilek yiyebilirim. In Turkey, we also have like this as a name for girls. Çilek, strawberry. Hey, strawberry, how are you? Hey, çilek. It's really true. Like some girls are named as like çilek in Turkey. Çilek, naber? Naber means like, hi, how are you, çilek? Like that. Portakal. Orange. I think it's same everywhere in the world, but in Turkey we think if you catch cold or flu and then if you eat orange, then you'll be get well soon. Maybe that's why I kind of don't like it, because like every time when I eat orange, portakal, I remember the old times when I got sick. Oh, every time when I got sick, I had to eat orange because my family just pushed me to eat orange. It reminds me kind of being sick. I'm sorry. Oh, so yeah, let's give example like that. If you catch flu, then just eat orange. Eğer grip olursanız, portakal yiyin. Okay, thank you guys for watching the video. Today we talked about fruits, which is my, I think, favorite topic. So I told you my favorite fruit and my least favorite fruit. So what are your favorites and which fruits you don't like or you dislike? Just tell me. And if you want to watch more videos or if you want to learn Turkish, then please visit turkishclass101.com. See you guys in the next video. Bye bye. Hi everyone, it's Celine. And today we're going to do Turkish Weekly Words. And I'm going to be teaching you some useful Turkish words that you can use in your daily life and so. So let's start. Okay, so today's topic is hobbies. Yay. In Turkish, actually, we also say hobby. So it's really close to English word. And I like to talk about hobbies, actually. I have so many hobbies. I'm so proud of it. Well, let's see the first word. Çizmek. To draw, yeah. I'm really bad at drawing, but let me give you a good example about it. Resim çizmeyi çok seviyorum. Resim çizmek is drawing a picture. Resim is picture. Resim çizmeyi çok seviyorum. Yeah, I really like to draw a picture as well, but since I'm really bad at it, I just don't draw anything. Nette surf yapmak. Surf the net. Net is net in Turkish as well. And surf is surf. I think it's pretty close. And yapmak is like to do the activity itself. So nette surf yapmak. Her gün nette surf yapıyorum. It's like I am surfing the net every day. Of course, I'm not doing, no, it's not true, but... Bir müzik aleti çalmak. Play a musical instrument. I really like that because I can also play something. I can play piano, so I'm gonna give example about it. Ben piyano çalıyordum. It means like, I was playing piano in the past. Satranç oynamak. Play chess. I did that too. Satranç oynamak, but of course, like... You should speak fast, right? So you should say satranç oynamak. I know you can do. I used to play chess actually when I was in middle school. So I was really bad at it too. I don't know why. I was really bad at everything. I tried. Anyway, if you want to ask, do you play chess? Then you go like satranç oynar mısın? Yüzmek. Yüzmek. It means swim. Swimming. Yeah, it's my favorite hobby. So that's why I picked it. You can say like havuzda mı? Yüzersin denizde mi? Would you prefer to swim in pool or in sea? Havuzda mı yüzersin denizde mi? Well, personally, I prefer pool. I'm such a princess, maybe. Thank you guys for watching. Today we talked about hobbies. So just let us know what are your favorite hobbies in comments below. If you want to watch more videos or if you want to learn Turkish, then please visit TurkishClass101.com. I'll be waiting. Okay, see you guys. Hi everyone, it's Celine and welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. As usual, I don't know the content of the lesson, so it's a surprise for me. Let's find out together. Colors. Renkler. Colors mean renkler. Kırmızı. Red. Red is my absolute favorite color. Kırmızı bir ruj almak istiyorum. Which means, I wanna buy a red lipstick. Sarı, yellow. Türkiye'de taksiler sarıdır. Taxis in Turkey are yellow. I think in the rest of the world it's yellow as well. In Japan it's green. No, green, white, maybe? Yeah. Oh, but we have pink actually. We have pink taxis, like recently. I wanna ride pink taxi. Mavi, blue. Mavi bir gökyüzü altında uyumak istiyorum. I said, I want to sleep under a blue sky. So poetic, maybe. Mavi bir gökyüzü altında uyumak istiyorum. Yeşil. Green. Green is my second favorite color. En iyi arkadaşımın göz rengi yeşil. My best friend's eye color is green. It is really green. He has really beautiful green eyes. Pembe. Pink. Türkiye'de pembe taksiler de var. In Turkey, there are pink taxis as well. Well, usually it's yellow, but recently we have pink. If you want to watch more videos, please visit TurkishClass101.com. So see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye. Hi everyone, it's Celine, and welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. Yay! Today, we're going to be talking about... I don't know yet. So let's see. Computer words. No, it's so hard. Oh, okay. How can I translate it? Computer is bilgisayar. Word is sözcük or kelime. Both are fine. So, bilgisayar, sözcükleri. Computer words. Dizüstü, bilgisayarı. Laptop computer. Dizüstü means like above the knee. I don't know why we are saying like that, but we are saying above the knee computer. It's laptop. Dizüstü bilgisayarın var mı? Do you have a laptop computer? But in Turkish, I don't know why. Maybe it's because it's too long to say dizüstü bilgisayarı. We also say laptop, but our pronunciation is kind of different. We're saying laptop. Some people say laptop, but some people say laptop, and it's both fine, I guess. Ekran, monitor. Ekran means monitor, but we also use it for to say screen, television screen or so. If you want to say televizyon ekranına çok yaklaşma. Don't get so close to television screen. And we use that word ekran. Televizyon ekranına çok yaklaşma. Çok yaklaşma means just don't get so close. So close means don't get close. Maybe it's yaklaşmak. Yaklaşma. Televizyon ekranına çok yaklaşma. Niye? Why? Because it's not good for your eyes, I guess. Fare. Mouse. In Turkish, fare also means mouse. I mean that animal. And also computer stuff. I think I really don't like mouses. Mice. I really don't like mice. Yeah. Let me give you an example like that. Masanın üstünde fare var. There's a mouse on the table. Masanın üstünde fare var. But which mouse? We don't know. Masa means table, and üst means on. The table means masanın üstünde. Var is var is word for there is, there are, var. Masanın üstünde fare var. Yazıcı, printer. Yazmak means to write. Yazdırmak means to print. Yazıcı means printer. So we just kind of arrange the verb. We just changed it and made it yazıcı. Example. Yazıcının mürekkebi bitmiş. Which means there is no ink in the printer or it's over. Mürekkep means ink. So yazıcının mürekkebi bitmiş. Then our last word is hoparlör. Hoparlör, which means speaker. It's important, right? Important to know. And my example is hoparlörün sesini çok açma. Don't make the speaker so loud. Hoparlörün sesini çok açma. Usually Turkish moms say that. So thank you guys for watching the video today. We talked about computer words and I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope you just learned something from me. If you want to watch more videos or if you want to learn Turkish, then please visit TurkishClass101.com. I'll be waiting for you. See you guys in the next video. Bye bye. Hi everyone, it's Selin. Merhaba, ben Selin. And welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. Nasılsınız? Nasıl gidiyor? The content of the lesson is a surprise for me, so let's find out together. Clothing actions. Okay. Clothing actions. Giymek. Put on. I think we use this word for all kind of clothes and shoes and everything. Bugün lacivert peyimi giydim. I wore my blue shirt today. Yes. Çıkartmak. Take off. We can use for shoes, dresses, clothes or your accessories. I'm taking off my watch. Saatimi çıkarıyorum. Şu an saatimi çıkarıyorum. I'm taking off now. Like that. Take off. But you don't use put on for watch. You say saati takmak, not saati giymek. And saati çıkarmak. Saat is watch. Saatimi çıkarıyorum. I'm taking off my watch. Yıkamak. Wash. I hate wash my clothes every day. Her gün kıyafetlerimi yıkıyorum. I wash my clothes every day. It's a big lie. I don't wash my clothes every day. Once in every 3 days, maybe? Kurutmak. Dry. Elbiselerimin kuruması uzun sürdü. It took long time for my clothes to be dried. In cold weathers, maybe. It takes long time for your clothes to dry. Ütülemek. Iron. Do you guys do? I think I don't do usually. I'm bad at ironing. Ütü yapmayı sevmiyorum. I don't like ironing. Ütü yapmayı sevmiyorum. Or ütülemeyi sevmiyorum. Ütü yapmak or ütülemek. Both are same. You can use both. It's fine. Thank you guys for watching and see you in the next video. If you want to watch more videos, then please visit turkishclass101.com. Bye-bye. Görüşürüz. Hi everyone, this is Celine and welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. So today, what do you think we'll be talking about? I'm so excited, so let's find out together. At the office, ofiste, masa, desk. Actually, in Turkish, we say sıra for desk. If you're in a school, then you can use sıra. But if you're in an office, then you should say masa instead of sıra. Masamda birçok kağıt var. There are so many papers in my desk. Bilgisayar. Computer. So if you want to say desktop in Turkish, then you go like masa üstü bilgisayar. Benim masa üstü bilgisayarım var. I have a desktop computer. Toplantı. Meeting. There are usually many meetings in companies, right? So yeah, we use the word toplantı. It's very, very common. If you want to complain to your coworkers, like, oh, today's meeting was so long, then you can say in Turkish, like, bugünkü toplantı çok uzundu. İş arkadaşı. Coworker. İş arkadaşlarınla iyi geçiniyor musun? Are you getting along with your coworkers? Maybe, like, your boss can ask you, right? Are you getting along with your coworker? Müdür. Manager. Boss or manager, we say müdür. There is always a manager in the office, right? Müdürünüz kim? Who's your manager? So thank you for watching the video. If you want to watch more Turkish videos, please visit turkishclass101.com. See you guys in the next video. Bye-bye. Hi everyone, it's Celine, and welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. Yay, I'm applauding myself. And today, we will be learning rooms. Rooms, really? Rooms? Okay. Oturma odası. Living room. Actually, in Turkish, oturma means like sitting down. So it's like sitting down room. Oturma odanız çok temiz. Çok beğendi. It means like, oh, your living room is really clean. I really liked it. Yemek odası. Dining room. In Turkey, I think we don't have like a separate dining room. Usually, maybe like living room, dining room, kind of same for us. Benim evimde yemek odası yok. There is no dining room in my house. Mutfak. Kitchen. Mutfakta vakit geçirmeyi seviyorum. Çünkü yemek yapmayı seviyorum. It's kind of long, right? It means like I like to spend time in kitchen because I like cooking. Banyo. Bathroom. I like to be in bathroom. We also say like take bath, taking bath. Bath is banyo, so we are using the same word. Banyo yapmak, taking bath. Or for bathroom, banyo. Banyoda ayağım kaydı. Which means my foot slipped in the bathroom. Çamaşır odası. Laundry room. Turkish housewives use that kind of room for like cleaning, doing laundry and ironing, that kind of stuff. So not every house has this kind of room, but sometimes I see that kind of room in some houses. We don't have. We have a really small house, like 3 people only. So we don't have. So thank you guys for watching today. Videomu izlediğiniz için çok teşekkür ederim. See you guys in the next video, I hope. If you want to watch more videos or if you want to learn Turkish, then you have to visit turkishclass101.com. Mutlaka bekliyorum. Kesinlikle gelin. I'm waiting for you. Like, let's learn Turkish together. So, yeah. See you guys in the next video. Bye-bye. Merhaba. Hi, everyone. It's Celine. Ben Celine. Nasılsınız? Welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. We don't know the content of the lesson yet. Let's find out together. In your wallet. Cüzdanında. Wallet means cüzdan. In your wallet is cüzdanında. So we're talking about that. Okay. Nakit para. Cash. Nakit para. Cash. I don't have it in my wallet. ATM'den nakit para çektim ve cüzdanıma koydum. ATM'den nakit para çektim ve cüzdanıma koydum. I withdrew money from ATM and I put in my wallet. I said. ATM is ATM. Kredi kartı. Credit card. kredi kartı. Bankalar kredi kartı vermek istiyor. Which means banks usually try to give credit cards. I mean to customers. Kupon. Kupon. Kuponunuz varsa indirim alabilirsiniz. Kuponunuz varsa indirim alabilirsiniz. If you have coupon, then you can get discount. Ehliyet. Driver's license. I'm not a very good driver. I think many people prefer cars, especially in Istanbul. Ehliyetim var ama araba süremiyorum. Ehliyetim var ama araba süremiyorum. I have driver's license, but I cannot drive. Anahtar. Key. Key. Anahtar. This is the key for my house. So, evimin anahtarı. My house key. Key. And so, what do I have in my wallet? This is my wallet. It looks good on me, right? So, what do I have? Money, cash, coins. Coins, can you hear? That's all for this video. If you want to watch more videos, please visit TurkishClass101.com. See you guys in the next video. Görüşürüz. Bye-bye.
Hi, everyone. I'm Gabriella. How are your Turkish listening skills? In this video, you'll have a chance to test them out with a quiz. First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
Bir erkek ve kız öğrenci ders programlarına bakarak konuşuyorlar. Erkek öğrencinin toplantı günündeki programını seçin.
Gelecek grup sunumumuz hakkında bir toplantı yapmamız gerekiyor.
Tamam, ne zaman boşsun?
Ben okula pazartesi, çarşamba ve perşembeleri geliyorum.
O zaman çarşamba veya perşembe İkimiz için de uygun olur. Çünkü ben de salı, çarşamba ve perşembeleri buradayım. Perşembe öğleden sonra nasıl o zaman?
Perşembe 3. periyoda kadar dersim var. 3. periyottaki ekonomi dersinden sonra olabilir. Fakat ondan sonra saat 5'te part-time işim var. Yani yalnızca 1 saat boşum.
O da biraz kısa. Çarşamba nasıl o zaman?
2. periyottaki çağdaş tarih ve 4. periyottaki uluslararası hukuk dersleri dışında boşum.
Peki, benim de 3. periyotta Asya tarihi ve akşamda part-time işim var. Sabah erkenden buluşup 2. periyot başlayana kadar konuşmaya ne dersin?
Sabahları uyanamıyorum ben. Neden perşembe buluşmuyoruz? Part-time işimi başka bir güne ayarlarım.
Peki. O zaman dersin bittikten sonra kafeteryaya gel. Erkek öğrencinin toplantı günündeki programını seçin. Bir erkek ve kız öğrenci ders programlarına bakarak konuşuyorlar. Erkek öğrencinin toplantı günündeki programını seçin.
Gelecek grup sunumumuz hakkında bir toplantı yapmamız gerekiyor.
Tamam, ne zaman boşsun?
Ben okula pazartesi, çarşamba ve perşembeleri geliyorum.
O zaman çarşamba veya perşembe ikimiz için de uygun olur. Çünkü ben de salı, çarşamba ve perşembeleri buradayım. Perşembe öğleden sonra nasıl o zaman?
Perşembe 3. periyoda kadar dersim var. 3. periyottaki ekonomi dersinden sonra olabilir. Fakat ondan sonra saat 5'te part-time işim var. Yani yalnızca 1 saat boşum.
O da biraz kısa. Çarşamba nasıl o zaman?
2. periyottaki çağdaş tarih ve 4. periyottaki uluslararası hukuk dersleri dışında boşum.
Peki, benim de 3. periyotta Asya tarihi ve akşamda part-time işim var. Sabah erkenden buluşup 2. periyot başlayana kadar konuşmaya ne dersin?
Sabahları uyanamıyorum ben. Neden perşembe buluşmuyoruz? Part-time işimi başka bir güne ayarlarım.
Peki, o zaman dersin bittikten sonra kafeteryaya gel.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time.
You are at a bus terminal where you're attempting to buy a ticket from a ticket counter. There are 4 different counters. Which counter should you line up at to go to the south side of the city? Which counter should you line up at to go to the south side of the city? The third counter is the counter for bus tickets that go to the south side of the city.
Şehrin güneyine.